romantic documents in the aesthetics. It would have talked about the blood of the nation, of the people. It would have talked about identity in those very fundamental, almost ethnic terms. It wouldn't have talked about this kind of large, almost ethereal, but compelling idea of this abstract set of rights. At least, I don't know if that's true, but I mean, I can imagine that being, it would have had a very different tone, had been written in a different era of history. I think that's an important point to make about it. There's a really good book by a historian named David Armitage called The Declaration of Armitage, I'll put it on the bibliography, A Global History of the Declaration of Independence, which is a really good read because he sort of walks you step by step through this argument in a way much more elegant than I'm doing for you here, that gives a sense of that connection to the meaning of the Declaration. And to this day, there are over 160 nations in the world that have adopted declarations of independence based to some degree on the American Declaration.